Welcome to BCT Standard Course Level 1. I'm Li Ming. Today, we will learn Lesson 4's Dialogue 3 and 4. We have learned how to say goodbye to the other person. Do you remember?
很好。
再见。
明天见。
Today, we will learn how to greet your friends or guests.Who you haven't seen in a long time.
好久不见。
您忙吗？
Okay, let's look at the new words. Please read with me.
忙
不
好久
吗
呢
From this picture, we know that this man is very busy with his work. Busy in Chinese is
忙.
Very busy is
很忙.
He is very busy is
他很忙.
This picture tells us that the man is very busy with work, not with his study. So how do we translate?He is very busy with his work.
他的工作很忙。
很好。
Let's add an adverbial time to this sentence.
Great.
下午
他的工作很忙。
Please read with me.
很忙。
他很忙。
他的工作很忙。
下午他的工作很忙。
Are they busy right now?
No.
No in Chinese is
不。
Not busy in Chinese is
不忙。
They are not busy because today is Sunday.So, they don't have to work. In Chinese, don't work is
不工作。
We have learned sentences with an adjectival predicate, such as
他们很忙。
The negative form of sentences with an adjectival predicate is generated by placing the negative adverb 不 before the adjective that functions as the predicate.So, the negative form of the sentence
他们很高兴
is
他们不高兴
Great! We have learned sentences with a verbal predicate as well. For example,
我姓李
王经理来公司
我认识你
The negative form is made by placing the adverb 不 before the verb, such as
我不姓李
王经理不来公司
我不认识你
Now let's do some exercises. Please change the following sentences into their negative forms.
他叫李静。
他不叫李静。
我们是朋友。
我们不是朋友。
明天李女士很忙。
明天李女士不忙。
我们银行很好。
我们银行不好。
Well done. Ma is used after sentence to indicate the interrogative mood. When ma is added to the end of a declarative statement, that statement is turned into a question. For example, hello in Chinese is
你好。
If we add ma at the end of
你好,
Then, this statement is changed into a question. The meaning of the sentence is changed from hello into how are you? The interrogative form of 他忙 is
他忙吗?
Let's see one more example.
他是王经理。
The interrogative form is
他是王经理吗?
To answer the question by the negative, drop the 吗 and insert a negative verb. To answer the question by the affirmative, drop the 吗 at the end of the question. To answer the question by the negative, drop the 吗 and insert a negative adverb, usually 不 before the verb or adjective. For example, when you answer the question,
你叫王静吗?
The affirmative form is,
我叫王静。
The negative form is, 我不叫王静。Now, please tell me the interrogative form, affirmative form, or negative form of the following sentences.
李女士不高兴。李女士高兴吗？李女士高兴。你工作吗？
我工作。
我不工作。我认识王经理。你认识王经理吗？我不认识王经理。
Good job! We have learned how to ask a question with 吗? Right now, we continue to learn how to make an abbreviated question with 呢? An abbreviated question with 呢 is made by adding 呢 directly after a pronoun or a noun. The meaning of the question, however, must be clearly indicated in the previous sentence. For example,
我很好，你呢?
In this sentence,
你呢? Means 你好吗?
The preceding sentence, 我很好。Provides the context.
我认识她。王小姐呢?
Here, the sentence 王小姐呢? Means
王小姐认识她吗?
Please tell me the meanings of the 呢 question in these two sentences. In the first sentence,
李经理呢?
Means
李经理忙吗?
In the second sentence,
李女士呢?
Means
李女士来吗?
Have you got the right answers? Now let's do some exercises. Please complete the following dialogues.Excellent. If you have not seen your friend for a long time, how would you greet him or her? We have learned see in Chinese is 见. Its negative form is
不见.
Long time in Chinese is 好久. So, long time no see is
好久不见.
To respond, you can simply repeat the same greeting. Now let's come to the text. Please look at the picture and the lesson 2 dialogue 3 first. Then answer the question according to the text.
李先生，好久不见。
好久不见，工作忙吗？
忙。你呢？
我也是。
Did you understand? How did Mr. Li reply when his friend said, long time no see to him? Yes.
好久不见。
Has Mr. Li been busy recently?
Yes. 李先生很忙。
Okay, please read with me.
李先生，好久不见。好久不见。
工作忙吗？
忙。你呢？
我也是。
Try without 拼音。
李先生，好久不见。好久不见。
工作忙吗？
忙。你呢？
我也是。
Good. Let's come to dialogue 4. Please listen carefully and answer the following questions.
您好，王小姐，欢迎您。
您好，李先生，好久不见。
好久不见，您忙吗？
不忙，请进。
When Mr. Li said, Hello, Miss Wang, welcome. How did Miss Wang reply?
您好，李先生，好久不见。
Has Miss Wang been busy recently?
王小姐，不忙。
Did you understand? Okay, right now, please read with me.
您好，王小姐，欢迎你。您好，李先生。好久不见，好久不见。您忙吗？
不忙，请进。
谢谢。
Now try without 拼音。
您好，王小姐，欢迎你。您好，李先生，好久不见。好久不见，您忙吗？
不忙，
请进。谢谢。
Good. Now, fill in the blanks with the given words.
上午，我很忙。
王经理明天不来公司。
我明天不工作，你呢？
我明天也不工作。
你是李好吗？
我不是。
好久不见，
好久不见。
Miss Li goes to find Mr. Wang, who is working in his office. Please complete the dialogue according to the context.
李小姐，欢迎，好久不见。
王先生，好久不见。
您工作忙吗？
忙。您呢？
我也很忙。
请进，
请坐。
谢谢。
Great.Today, we have learned how to greet someone that you haven't seen for a long time.
好久不见。
We have learned how to ask the other person's work.
工作忙吗？
Try to call 5 Chinese friends or guests that you haven't seen for a long time outside of class. Okay, see you next time.